Cryptozoology is the study of creatures that are rumoured to exist. These creatures haven't been scientifically proven, but some of the legendary creatures turned out to be real. Some interesting reports that have emerged from various corners of the planet is that the prehistoric creatures somehow managed to survive mass extinction events. Many places have their own stories about these creatures, and one of these places is the Wild West. For years now, people have come forward with their reports, and they mostly detail encountering large reptilian creatures. These can only be described as similar looking to dinosaurs, and every witness who has seen them has agreed to this. One of the most common creatures seen in this region is the large pterosaurs that used to roam the sky. These were avian reptiles that grew to enormous sizes. They were most commonly sighted throughout the 1800s and onwards. This led many to believe that they somehow outlived their dinosaur cousins. Although in recent years, they've been given the name of thunderbirds. Although the name might not indicate a singular species, the thunderbird has the appearance of a large single bird seen flying overhead in different parts of the world. These sightings and birds were given the names thunderbirds as they shared a lot of characteristics with various stories. This included the ancient Native American traditions and mythologies surrounding a large flying creature referred to as the Thunderbird. This has left many wondering, however, if the creature is a modern-day sighting of a pterosaur. Additionally, the Thunderbird is described as being the size of a man when standing upright, with a wingspan over 16 feet in length. This has left many cryptozoologists working around the clock to calculate its possible flight patterns and capability of sustained flight given its size. It's due to this that it's been theorized by cryptozoologists that Thunderbird originally was referred to by Native American traditions. This was because the creature would follow the upwind drafts created during a large thunderstorm to sustain their weight, size, and movement. This is very similar to the way modern-day eagles ride up the side of mountain currents to gain height, with little work required on their part. A normal-sized bird would be torn up to unsustainable heights during a thunderstorm, and might find themselves in unstable flight positions, causing them to be thrown to and fro. But a bird the size of the Thunderbird would be able to stabilize their flight due to their weight and size, even when affected by such forces. These creatures are still being encountered today, and each report is similar to the next. One thing that does change is the creature's wingspan. Some have reported it's just over 20 feet, while others have suggested that the creature possesses a wingspan of over 40 feet. One story tells of a load of cowboys that got into trouble with one of these creatures. The year was 1880, and every so often there would be whispers of these giant birds. Those who lived in the Wild West during this time were said to be very well aware of them, as every so often they would fly over the town. On this particular occasion, the location was Tombstone, Arizona. Two ranchers had seen one of these creatures fly overhead and decided to pursue it. They were warned by other locals to stay away from the creatures, as they were known to attack humans. However, they didn't listen, and so went on horseback to track down the flying giant. The two men were said to have tracked the animal for several hours. They saw it resting on the ground after it had been flying. They recalled that it looked tired and that its size was much bigger than what they originally thought. Once on the ground, the two men then started to fire at the creature, managing to wound it in the process. It again took flight, but as it was doing this, the men continued to fire. During this battle, the creature then set its attention to the men and started to attack. While trying to defend itself though, it hit the ground, only causing itself more damage. The men were finally able to take down the creature, and once on the ground, they measured it. Reports suggest it was over 90 feet in length. Up until now, only a few people had seen these flying reptiles up close, and the two men were excited to bring the animal back to town. They recalled that it had two large feet that would join to the body. Its wings were just as impressive and could fold under the body when the creature was resting. The head of the beast was between 5 and 7 feet in length. It had a strong jaw that was filled with dozens of razor-sharp teeth. It's not known what happened to its body once it was brought back to town. Although these stories sound outlandish and completely made up, there is some photographic evidence that back up these claims. Modern science tells us, however, that these stories are completely untrue. The photographs in question are interesting, but many of them are hard to track to an original source. They usually feature various men standing around a large avian-like creature. They do match modern recreations of pterosaurs, something that men of these times most likely wouldn't have known. This photograph shows five men standing around a large bird-like creature. The story behind this one isn't known. However, a few of the men can be seen with guns, which points towards the idea that this animal was shot down by the men. No more information can be found on the photograph. The next photograph is believed to have been taken during the 1950s, and it shows a man holding up one of these creatures. Researchers have suggested that this one was a baby, or a juvenile. What's interesting, though, is that it doesn't show a massive pterosaur, causing some to think that it's more genuine than the rest. This photo is the clearest one to date. The last photograph is said to be a thunderbird. Once again, though, not much information can be gathered about where it originated from. Although, some cryptozoologist researchers who have studied the image have said this is the real deal. All of these sightings and encounters have led people to carry out further research. This is because they think there's a real possibility the pterosaurs are still living in limited numbers in remote parts of the world. Over the past few decades, many have claimed to have seen a pterosaur. Most of the alleged sightings have been in North America. A few sightings of the pterosaur have been reported in Africa as well. During the earlier half of the 20th century, some locals in Zambia claimed to have seen a giant flying reptile that was very aggressive and that would try to attack the humans. The description of the flying reptile indicated it was a pterosaur or a similar creature. One mysterious location that's said to be home to mysterious ancient creatures is that of the Bridgewater Triangle. Definitely one of the strangest and most well-reported areas featuring mysterious sightings is the Bridgewater Triangle. It's similar to that of the Bermuda Triangle, in which it seems that strange and anomalous properties focus their events to encompass an area spanning roughly 200 square miles. This encompasses the majority of southeastern Massachusetts, located in the United States. The land itself is determined via referencing specific boundaries, such as the towns Abington and Freetown, that make up two of the 3 points of the triangle. This creates an area of land in between that seems to be a focused area of paranormal activity. These dense forested areas seem to hold a wide variety of different unexplainable sightings, along with terrifying encounters with monsters and supernatural entities. Men and women have reportedly encountered numerous different types of Sasquatches in the area and seen large birds flying overhead that are commonly described as massive thunderbirds. Not only that, but strange animal mutilations have been witnessed that seem to be the work of darker cults. This has caused some to speculate that the place is haunted by various entities. This has led to a wide variety of strange disappearances as well, of which locals blaming the unexplainable paranormal phenomenon as the cause of these tragedies. Interestingly, various studies have been carried out, and the Bridgewater Triangle lays claim to being one of the most haunted places in the world, along with being a place that has a high number of cryptid reports. To this day, there seems to be no real explanation as to the cause of the mass number of sightings, disappearances, or the strange nature of the dense forested areas in the region. As of today, it's not known what these creatures are and what people are encountering. One thing that is known is that reports span across the entire planet, with people even coming forward from remote locations to report their sightings. Some of these locations don't have access to books of these kinds, so wouldn't have a motive to pin it on a flying reptile. So what do you make of these mysterious stories? Be sure to let us know your thoughts in the comments section below, and help us by growing this community whilst working to solve these unexplained mysteries. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos.